This is Will Richmond from Video News, and what I'd like to do today is show how the new Comcast X1 set-top box is handling the NBC Olympics live extra app as well as on-demand clips. Before we go ahead and get into that, I want to talk a little bit about how the experience looks on an iPad, just to provide a little bit of context. If you've already used NBC Live Extra on the iPad or other devices, feel free to skip ahead to the X1 part of this demo. But for those of you that haven't, I want to just provide a little bit of context for how this app works on the iPad before we go over into check it out on the X1. So this again is NBC Sports Live Extra. This is an authenticated app from NBC Olympics. All of the live streams are available here. I have already authenticated previously with Comcast, which is my operator. So when I come in, I'm immediately granted access to all the different live streams at the current time. And you can see that you can scroll through what's available currently. I'm going to go ahead and just choose freestyle skiing men's half pipe, and I'll go ahead and click on that. And the first thing that we're going to see is an ad. Pretty much a common experience here before all of the videos that are shown, that there's at least one 15-second, if not two or even three sometimes, ads that are shown. This is all powered by Adobe Primetime, the ad experience I've previously written about. But now we're right here, we're taken into the, again, the live stream of the half pipe. And we can see the quality is really nice. I'm not going to spend a lot of time here on the video. I just wanted to provide a quick insight into how quickly you can get there. So let's go ahead and close that out. And that's live. Now let's say you wanted to go ahead and look at a clip from a prior sport, something else that happened. So now what you can do is actually click over here on Open Highlights and Results app. That's going to take you into the NBC Olympics app. So now we're out of Live Extra and we're into NBC Olympics. And we'll see that that is brought to us by GE as the sponsor here. And we can just get a sense of what the timing is here about how these apps load, because that'll be worth keeping in mind when we go over and take a look at X1 as well. So now we're into the NBC Olympics app. Again, this is not Live Extra. This is an app that has a lot of different videos and headlines, the medal standings, a lot of other information. What we're going to do here is just say we wanted to take a look at the bronze performance by the USA1 two-man bobsled team. That's the bobsled that was built by BMW, got a lot of publicity during the Olympics in the run-up here. And so what we're going to do now is just click on By Sport and note the layout. All the different sports have their own tile here: alpine skiing, biathlon, bobsled, etc. I'll go ahead and click on bobsled, and now I'm taken into an environment that has news, videos, and photos. And I'll click on videos. And just again, note how this is loading. We'll want to compare that to the X1 experience. And now I can scroll here, and I'll choose Holcomb and Langton take home bronze in two-man. And I can click on that, and the video will start playing. First, we're going to see an ad. Again, no frequency capping, as I mentioned before. Interesting experience. Here, we'll just see one 15-second ad for Coke. And then we'll be taken right in to see that experience on the on-demand clip. And here we go into the bobsled, and this is the exact clip. This is a 4.5 minute clip of the men's USA1 bobsled team, the two-man team. This team won bronze yesterday, so pretty nice video quality there. We're not going to go ahead and watch that. It's just something that's pretty cool. It's available online there. So that is basically the experience on the iPad between the Live Extra app and the NBC Olympics app. Now let's go take a look at how Comcast is handling all this video in X1. This is Will Richmond, and I'm back now. I want to show how the Comcast X1 set-top box handles the NBC Olympics Live Extra app. So if you haven't seen X1 before, what it does is you can quickly scroll through things like what's on live, what's on DVR, what's on demand, and the apps. Now today there are not a lot of apps available. You can see down here, there's the NBC Live Extra app. We'll go in there in a second. There's just Pandora, Facebook, headlines, and photos. Question is, of course, what is Comcast going to put up here in the app section at some point down the road? But let's go ahead and click on Live Extra. Again, I want you to get a sense of how X1 handles this. X1 is now going to be connecting to the internet and taking its cues from there. So what we see now is a rendering, as we saw in the Live Extra app on the iPad. We see a rendering of all the different sports that are available. Let's quickly go over to take a look at what's available live right now. And we can see it's Tuesday the 18th. We go into live now. Bobsled, there's our freestyle skiing. Let's go ahead and click on that. And we're going to be taken into the live stream, the exact same live stream that we saw before on the iPad. We're going to go into and now see on X1. We can give that a little bit of volume, and there's the men's half pipe, the exact same stream that we were just watching on the iPad, now available here on X1, available on demand. So I'll go ahead and just mute that. And now, in addition to what's available live, I just want to quickly show how X1 also makes available access to all the different video clips that we were watching before on the iPad as well. So I'll go ahead and exit out of that. And now what I'll do instead is go up here to All Sports. And this is the main navigation area to switch back and forth between the sports. Now you can see the big blue circles. If they have a little green circle below them, that means that there's a live sport going on, a live stream going on right now. And so we can look at, there's the freestyle skiing. We just saw that the live was there. If we click on that, the men's half pipe qualifying. I just want to quickly show what happens if you go to a sport that does not have anything live right now. So let's go to short track speed skating. We select on that. Notice it says there are no live events. Press OK to watch highlights. I'll go ahead and do that. And now what's happening is that X1 is seamlessly taking you over into the on-demand environment where you can now select from a bunch of different clips. And again, I just want to show how quickly you can move around through X1 very quickly, but I'm going to jump out of this on-demand just to show how it seamlessly took me over there. I'm going to go back into the main menu for the Live Extra. Here we are again showing the nav by sports, and let's say I go ahead over here into bobsled because I want to try to find that clip of the men's USA 1 bronze performance for, yesterday, the two-man bobsled using the BMW sled that was written about so much. Let's see if I can. There's bobsled. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and click on it. Now, here's something that's a little bit funky. If there's a live event right now, which there is clearly, then it does not show you access to the on-demand clips. This is a little bit of a funky UI experience here. What it demands is actually that you go back over into on-demand directly, which you can quickly do going back here to select on. Let's go back into on-demand, and there's on-demand. And then now we can select Sochi 2014 Olympics. We click on that, and now if we go to top highlights, we'll go ahead and find the bobsled. And I think if I just scroll down a little bit here, there's the bobsled. Again, I want you to notice how quickly X1 takes me through these different selections. Now I see a bunch of different video clips, highlights. I can quickly scroll down and I'm gonna find the men's two-man highlights, USA 1. Take a look also, very important, the metadata, American Steve Holcomb and Steve Langton sit in third place after two heats. I watch on demand, click to watch on demand. Now I'm going directly into the Xfinity on demand library. It's going to bring up that exact same clip. One thing you'll notice is that there is not an ad here inserted in the, there's just this little upfront sort of promotion, but I don't think we're going to see an ad here on X1, but let's go ahead and just give it a second. And let's see if we can get the clip going. There's the Citibank slate. And here we go, I think now. I'll give it a little bit of volume. And bobsled, remember this exact same clip that we just saw a couple minutes ago on the iPad. This is the men's two-man team. You're able to quickly select and watch it. And there it is, the exact same clip. Two-man team that won the bronze. So now I can go back if I want to, if I want to get out of that. I can just very easily click the main controller, get back to apps, select the Live Extra, and I'm back into the Live Extra app. See how X1 is connecting to the internet very quickly, and now I'm back to the main nav. So that's just a quick tour of the Comcast X1 set-top box, how it's handling the NBC Olympics Live Extra app, as well as the on-demand clips and Xfinity On Demand. There's been a lot written about, a lot talked about how Comcast is investing in the X1 platform, and I think it really does kind of show how the company is trying to essentially merge the traditional linear experience with an on-demand experience, with an online video and app-based experience, sort of blurring the lines as we saw. Look how similar the experience was between what was available on the iPad versus the X1. So pretty interesting developments here by Comcast with their X1 set-top box platform that I thought was worthwhile taking a look at.